July 2011. Hundreds gather outside the courthouse in Orlando, Florida to wait for a verdict in what many say was the death penalty trial of the century, the case against Casey Anthony.
As to the charge of first-degree murder, verdict as to count one, we, the jury, find the defendant not guilty.
The case ended as dramatically as it started, with a call to 911 from a panicked grandmother.
There's something wrong. I found my daughter's car today, and it smells like there's been a dead body in the damn car.
We had a missing child that was absolutely adorable, and a beautiful young woman mother, 22 years of age, and they had the grandmother screaming that on the phone.
Suspicion fell on Casey Anthony. Police believed her stories weren't adding up. Her little girl Kaylee taken by the nanny that no one could find. And pictures like these suggesting that while her daughter was missing, she was partying, sparked public outrage.
Did you kill Kaylee?
Chaney Mason, an experienced death penalty lawyer, was watching from the sidelines while Anthony's attorney, Jose Baez, was coming under scrutiny for his lack of experience. Baez asked for help. Mason decided to meet with Anthony.
They brought her into the room, and I'm sitting there looking at this. A child herself, and said, this can't be.
But it was. The state gave notice they were seeking the death penalty against Anthony for the premeditated murder of Kaylee, whose skeletal remains were finally found close to the family's home in Orlando, Florida, about 5 months after she went missing.
Could she look you in the eye?
Oh, yes.
What was her demeanor?
She was afraid, unsure about really anything and what was going to happen, how it was going to happen.
Mason, in his new book, Justice in America, describes for the first time calling Casey's parents, George and Cindy, to his office late on a Friday afternoon, shortly before jury selection began. Mason had just received word that Casey's handwritten letters describing sexual abuse by her father were about to be released publicly.
We had them one at a time come into my personal office and made the announcement and told them, Monday's going to be a bad day for you, George. And I felt man to man, I'll tell you in advance.
What was his reaction?
Basically none. He looked at me and kind of turned sideways a little bit and clapped his hands down on his thighs and let out a big sigh and didn't say anything.
George Anthony never admitted to Mason any inappropriate conduct with Casey.
Then called mom in. Cindy, and told her, and she immediately welled up with tears and emotion and cried and was very upset.
Once a jury was selected, this death penalty trial began, and Jose Baez turned the case on its head by announcing this bombshell in his opening statement.
And it all began when Casey was 8 years old and her father came into her room and began to touch her inappropriately.
I didn't know that he was going to say that. I was concerned about that because I knew that we didn't have the ability to prove that unless George got on the stand and confessed.
Prosecutors made George Anthony their first witness.
Have you ever sexually molested your daughter, Casey Anthony?
No, sir.
Testimony in the case continued for weeks as witness after witness and forensic experts from around the country took the stand in this circumstantial case. While the trial was being hotly contested in and out of the courtroom, secret plea discussions that would have spared Anthony's life were beginning. It was Anthony who shut them down.
Casey wouldn't have any part of it. She was very angry about that. She didn't want to talk about it. She didn't want to hear it.
So the trial went on, and then that verdict heard round the world.
Juror number 12, were these your two incorrect verdicts?
Yes.
Thank you.
Anthony was free, but the hatred against her was stronger than ever.
Kaylee! Kaylee!
The public's opinion of Casey Anthony hasn't changed much. Chaney and his wife Shirley have remained close to Anthony. They share these pictures exclusively with CNN.
She does not have any blood family anymore. She has no contact with them.
No contact with her mother?
I think she's had a few phone conversations with her over the years. That's it. No contact.
Her father?
None.
Her brother?
None. Not likely to ever be. She hasn't been freed from her incarceration yet. Because she can't go out. She can't do anything.
I know that she has very, very strong feelings about what has happened to her. I also know she's very saddened by her loss, and she never will forget her daughter, Kaylee, ever.
Jean Casarez, CNN, New York.